many people over the last 4 or 5 years have become familiar with the term methylation defect. And so more and more people are being tested and finding that that's one of their problems. So what in the world is a methylation defect? Well, a methyl group is a carbon with 3 hydrogens on it. And that particular methyl group is needed for many of the biochemical reactions in the body to function normally. So we have a molecule that's called SAM because its real name is S-Adenosyl methionine, which is hard to say and remember. So SAM has a bunch of methyl groups. So it goes wandering on the body looking for somebody who needs one. It says, oh, here's one, and gives it to them and goes on and passes them off to whoever needs them. But pretty soon, SAM runs out of methyl groups. And when that happens, SAM becomes a different molecule. So when SAM runs out of methyl groups, it becomes a molecule called homocysteine. Now, homocysteine is known to be toxic, particularly to the heart. But the way things normally are supposed to work is that homocysteine is given more of these methyl groups by certain particularly vitamin type molecules. So for example, there's vitamin B12 is called cobalamin. So there's cyanocobalamin, and there's various other forms of cobalamin, but the only one that has a methyl group on it is methylcobalamin. So you need an enzyme system to say, take off the cyano from the cobalamin and add methyl back in, and now methylcobalamin can go give its methyl group to homocysteine to help turn it back into SAM. And types of folic, and then there's a molecule that has methyl groups in it, et cetera. So it's not so important what those are, it's just that we have several molecules that are designed to be able to give their methyl groups to homocysteine to turn it back into SAM. And now SAM can go back on its circuit and start handing out care packages to everybody who needs a methyl group. Obviously, you get into trouble when you don't have the enzymes to take and turn those various things like B12 into the methyl form. And so that whole system stops. And so you start running out of methyl groups. And that's called a methylation defect. So for example, in the products that we developed, everything that can be methylated is methylated so that when you consume our nutritional product, no matter whether or not you have the methylation problem, it's going to make your body function normally because the methyl groups are there to give SAM the methyl groups to give away to the people in need. So it's important to be able to know that you need that, or if you don't, go get the test that you need it. If you simply take the nutritional product that has it, then it's not going to be a problem.